sure there's a time in every reviewer's life where the thought process that comes with parsing with a feasible review for a particular title is overwhelmingly perplexing. In my case, Closed Game is where I fall into that spectrum. This is a highly erotic visual novel, with the primary purpose being to emit sexualized excitement for the players. But that's not to say it's devoid of any meaningful characterization. Surprisingly enough, the interactions between some of the cast and the inward conflicts they face are worthy of merit. Be wary though, for those not accustomed to especially hardcore erages, you best find something else. Closed Game follows the perspective of the protagonist, Tugo, who is a mechanic, barely making enough to scrape by but contend with his life. He is an unambitious person by nature, which serves to annoy his childhood friend, Celicia. Celicia is a foul-mouthed bounty hunter who constantly questions Tugo's career choice due to his lack of comfortable profit. Despite how often the two bicker, it's clear they deeply care for one another. At this time, the Earth resides on a degraded society, where natural resources have begun to reach their limits, and the class divide has widened considerably. With how miserable daily life is, many on Earth look to the sky for hope, as there's a paradise known as Salem Herbs. In this heavenly utopia, any concerns for basic livelihood are non-existent. After the narrative's opening, we meet a friendly mentor of sorts named George, but then tragedy strikes and the lewd killing game truly begins, which is probably what you're mostly interested in. So let's get to it. Closed Game consists of 6 participants attempting to reach safe zones in new biomes each day. Each contender wears a bracelet that acts as a compass and also warns of incoming danger. The rules are purposely vague, simple, and flexible thanks to the overseers Celine and Michiko. They find dubious joy from watching the game play out, and even with death in the cards for the participants, their understanding of human decency and common sense is far from what we consider normal. The remaining characters are Lacey, Kokona, and Marielle. These characters are all absurdly attractive women, but hey, I'm not complaining. For as attractive as the latter three girls are, the actual characterization is not as enticing. Their depth is only present when pursuing their routes, as most scenes involving the main narrative portray them as relatively two-dimensional. This is a shame because Celicia is infinitely more enticing throughout the common routes. While she is a tsundere and spouts swears non-stop, she does legitimately mean well for Tugo. This is depicted fairly decently throughout progression, unlike the rest of the female cast personalities, which come off as more tacked on than anything. In regards to each of the routes, their qualities ultimately depended on your kinks. Some baseline character conflicts and interactions carry events forward, but let's be honest, they're not the focus here. Each of the girls embodies obvious archetypes, and they are depicted in age scenes, of which there are many. I'm not going to detail the sexual scenes themselves, but it's impossible not to bring them up, given the frequency in this title, so you should know beforehand that the age scenes in this game are intense, to put it mildly. If you tend to play non-erotic visual novels or mainly stick to vanilla ones, you may want to consider this experience. The art style of this title is utterly magnificent. Each of the environments is adequate for sure. Though the true majesty of the art comes with these girls. Just looking at the way they are drawn alone is enough to show the many, many hours that have gone into their designs. Aside from the plump bodies and assets each girl houses, their facial reactions are captivatingly realistic. Their eyes, for instance, are not just standardized large anime ones that have come to be expected, and are instead more dialed down to a feasible immersive size and shape. This serves to make several scenes infinitely more impactful than they would have otherwise been. As a whole, I was loosely satisfied with the endings of each route. I can't say that they were fulfilling, since most of them felt like kicks in the gut or cop-outs. However, this negativity regarding the quality of the endings falls in line with the attitudes of Celine and Michiko, who merely see the game as a spectacle and nothing more. In that sense, I can fathom some twisted triumph these conclusions can instill upon select players. The despair of the killing game is an intoxicating delight for Michiko and Celine. If you can detach yourself from the humanity of the oppressed cast, you can too derive some forbidden sense of pleasure. I couldn't help but feel somewhat guilty after most of these scenes and endings, wishing for these characters to receive happier outcomes. These were the hands they were dealt, though, and it falls in line with the darkly depraved decadence exuded by the overseers of the game. I do appreciate the sense of unease provided, if nothing else. Closed Game is a highly erotic experience that is highly dependent on the player's kinks. The masterfully alluring art style and occasionally engaging characterization do add visual quality outside of the erotic presentation. If you are intrigued by the prospects of this experience and are prepared to witness deprived misery, this is worth the purchase. The story doesn't land for each route, but it's still one that might be worth a playthrough. Noisy Pixel is giving Closed Game a 7 out of 10. Thank you for watching. Please read the full review at noisypixel.net. Noisy Pixel is run by a group of gamers who work hard to deliver news, reviews, previews, and more. Please subscribe to keep up with all our future content. Noisy Pixel.